Hi guys, welcome everybody in the video. This is for class 11th Hornbill and it's the first chapter, The Portrait of Old Lady. This is written by Khushwant Singh and in this video we are going to learn its question answers. We will discuss its question answers there. And this is your part 2 of the video, because in the first part I taught you about the word to word explanation, or you can say summary, and some important words of the chapter also. So if you would like to watch its prior video, you can just go to the channel and select that. And one more thing, don't be confused, every kind of material will be found there, so you have to just subscribe the channel. Go to the playlist and select your desired video about Hornbill, snapshot, writing section and grammar also, right? So you should never be confused about it. Whatever is there, that is available on the channel already. Now in this video, we are going to learn the Portrait of Lady question answers. So let's come there. So very first, the first question is given there. Mention the three phrases of the author's relationship with the grandmother before he left the country and when he was going to study abroad. So mention three phrases. Three phrases means you have to describe the three conditions there that was between the relationship. Relationship was between author and grandmother. So you have to tell the three stages or three phases of their relationship before going to abroad. So what are the three phases there? In the first phase, their relationship was very, very good. Why the relationship was very good? Because both of they were living in the village and they were spending most of the time with each other, right? Second phase start there when they were shifted in the city, and in the city, because their parents were already settled there in the city, that's why they called grandmother and grandson in the city. And after visiting the city, now grandson Khushwant Singh was busy in his own study, and now grandmother was no more getting chance to speak to him. She was no more getting chance to solve his problems there and to teach him any of the subject, because now he was studying in the English medium school and it was not possible for her to tell the solution of that one. And in third phase, what happened? When the author went to the university, now the author went to the university and he was given a room of his own, and this time there was a great change in their relationship, and their relationship was weaker in this part. Okay, so their relationship was weaker in this part, and the link between them, the same room, snapped there, and she became quieter and private and kept the spinning wheel all the day long. Means this time in the third phase, now grandson was just living in his own life, okay, and grandmother was keeping herself busy in a spinning wheel. Spinning wheel means charkha katne mein. Okay, so all day she was just spinning the wheel there, and now she was making herself busy in her own only. And second, you know, always she was feeding the sparrows in the city. Okay, and third, she was telling the beads of her rosary. Telling the beads of rosary means telling the beads means japna. Beads means man ke, rosary means mala. To apne mala ke man ke yahan pe japti rehti hai. Okay, so now come to the second question. And what is the second question? Mention three reasons why the author's grandmother was disturbed when he started going to the city school. You have to tell the three reasons why author's grandmother was disturbed. Why she was disturbed there? Why she was disturbed when he was going to city school? So first of all, you know what happened, as you come to know after watching at the first video, that grandmother was no more happy with the subjects of English medium school, because all the subjects were of English medium. And secondly, she was not able to tell the solution. She was not able to help him in his homework anymore. Third was there, she hated their music lessons there, because she thought that music lesson was music was just only for the beggars and herald. Herald means jaise veshaye hoti hain ki unke liye jo hai wo music subject hote hain, means music should not be as a subject for the normal person. And one more is there, that there were no teachings about golden scriptures. That's why also she was annoyed there. Why she was annoyed? Because religious books like God related books or scriptures also released craziest book. So such kind of things were not in his subjects, because all the subjects were English medium and no religious content was given in his subject. That's why she was annoyed there. So these were the three reasons. The next one is, the mention three ways in which the author's grandmother spent her days after he grew up. So you have to tell the three ways once again there. So how did she, his grandmother changed a lot since he grew up. Means जैसे वो बड़ा हो गया तो उसकी grandmother के अंदर changes आ जाते हैं. कैसे वो change आते हैं? Grew होना means as he was growing up. वो जैसे बड़ा होता जाता, because now they were in the city and when they were in the city at that time, what happened there? That time both of they had many more distances between them. Why there was distances there? Because there was a change in the school. A lot of change was in the school, and grandmother was no more able to help him in his homework. So they were having lots of distances there. She would spend her day in spinning the wheel, chanting the prayer. Chanting the prayer means singing the prayer, and feeding the sparrows. So these were three changes or three ways with the help of which author's grandmother was spending her day. So which are the 3 days? Spinning the wheel, charkha katne mein, chanting prayers means singing the prayer, and feeding the sparrows in the city. Next is, mention the odd way in which the author's grandmother behaved just before she died. Just before she died. So what was her behavior just before the die? What was his behavior? Her behavior, sorry. She didn't pray the evening before dying. Marne se pehle, usne us evening mein pray nahi ki thi. She collected the women. So what she did? To usne kiya kya tha? She collected the women from the neighborhood and started singing homecoming of warriors. Homecoming of warriors means जो लड़ाई से वापिस आते हैं, युद्ध को जीत के आते हैं, जैसे हमारे जो हमारे soldiers होते हैं वहां पे border के ऊपर होते, तो क्या होते हैं जो वो victory हासिल करके वापिस आते हैं, तो उनकी वापसी में जैसे जो songs गुनगुनाए जाते हैं, patriotic songs होते हैं. So the same she was also singing with the women, and she collected the women from the neighborhood. Like this she was just singing the songs warriors, for the warriors homecoming, or you can say for the she was just singing the patriotic songs there, and with the help of the drum, right? So this was the great change in her, that day she didn't pray, that evening she didn't pray before the death. And the next morning, what happened? The next morning she fell ill and she was sick, and doctor was called there, and when the doctor called, doctor said that no, it's okay, she will recover very soon. But what was the reply of grandmother? Grandmother replied that no, her end was near and she will be no more after some time. That's why she started praying peacefully while lying on her bed. Means when she was lying on the bed, when she was ill, so she was in the bed, and that time she was just telling the beads of a rosary, and she refused to talk to anyone during her last hours. So she said that I would not like to talk to anyone else, and I will just only pray, I will just only tell the beads of my rosary. Means last time वो ये कहती है कि वो अपने God को remember करना चाहते हैं. She doesn't want to speak to anyone else, and she even requested to everybody to leave her alone. So it was her action when she was near the death there, right? Next one. Mention the three ways in which sparrows expressed their sorrow when the author's grandmother died. So what was the sparrow's expression? What was the sparrow's expression when they show their sorrow? Means apna dukh, apna grief unhone, sparrows ne kaise show kiya yahan par? Kaise? And how did they come to know that the grandmother was no more there? So what happened there with the sparrows? How they behaved there? So the grandmother used to feed the sparrows. You know it very well that grandmother was feeding the sparrows in her veranda each day. Each day means har ek din. हर एक दिन वो क्या करती थी, स्पैरोज को फीडिंग करवाती थी. शी डेवलप्ड अ स्पेशल रिलेशनशिप विद देम, उनके साथ उसका स्पेशल रिलेशनशिप था. व्हेन शी डाइड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ स्पैरोज एक्सप्रेस्ड देयर सोरो, क्योंकि अब इवनिंग का टाइम हो गया था, और इवनिंग टाइम में क्या था, स्पैरोज को आना ही था फीडिंग लेने के लिए यहाँ पे. एंड व्हेन द स्पैरोज अराइव्ड देयर, दे वर शॉक्ड टू सी दैट ग्रैंडमदर वाज नो मोर. एंड व्हेन दे सॉ द ग्रैंडमदर वाज नो मोर, सो दोज थाउजेंड्स ऑफ स्पैरोज एक्सप्रेस्ड देयर सोरो बाय सिटिंग इन अ स्कैटर्ड वे. स्कैटर्ड वे मींस कोई इधर बैठ गई, कोई उधर बैठ गई, कोई ऊपर बैठ गई, कोई नीचे बैठ गई, मीन्स सबके सब वहां पर स्कैटर्ड वे में, बिखरे हुए वे में वहां पे बैठ जाती है अराउंड हर इन द वरांडा एंड दे डिडंट चिप. उन्होंने उस दिन चिपिंग की साउंड भी नहीं की, जैसे होता ना कि देखो कितनी समझदार है यहाँ पर, कितनी इंटेलिजेंट है यहाँ पे, कि जो स्पैरोज है वो समझ गए कि अब ग्रीफ का टाइम है, मोरिंग का टाइम है, शोक का टाइम है, तो फिर उस टाइम उन्होंने चिपिंग भी नहीं की. देखो कितनी अटैचमेंट थी, उनको पता चला कि ग्रैंड मदर वॉज नो मोर, दैट्स वाई दे वर नॉट इवन चिरपिंग देयर एंड देयर वॉज अ कंप्लीट साइलेंस. द ऑथर्स मदर ट्राइड टू फीड, ऑथर्स मदर, अब यहाँ पर ऑथर की जो मदर है, जो खुशवंत सिंह की मदर है, उसने सोचा भाई स्पैरोज आ गए, चलो स्पैरोज को तो मैं कुछ ना कुछ फीड करवा ही देती हूँ. तो स्पैरोज को फीड करवाने के लिए उसने क्या किया, उसने यहाँ पर छोटे छोटे चपाती के क्रम्स और ब्रेड क्रम्स यहाँ पर डाले. क्रम्स मीन्स स्मॉल पीसेस, वेरी स्मॉल पीसेस. तो जो चपाती के स्मॉल पीसेस थे वो उसने यहाँ पर डाले. ऑथर्स मदर, ऑथर की मदर ने डाले, बिकॉज ऑथर की ग्रैंड मदर तो डाइड हो चुकी थी एंड नाउ ऑथर्स मदर वॉज प्लेइंग द रोल. सो ऑथर्स मदर ट्राइड टू फीड दैम बाय ब्रेकिंग द ब्रेड एंड थ्रोइंग इट इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैम. उसने उनके सामने डाल दिया. But what happened? But they didn't eat anything. They didn't pick even a single crumb. They didn't pick even a single crumb from there. And when the family carried grandmother's corpse, or jab family us grandmother ki corpse ko dead body ko corpse means dead body, us dead body ko wahan se le jaati hai antim vidai ke liye, then All flew away quietly. सबकी सब देखो यहाँ से उड़ जाती हैं और यहाँ पे उड़ने के बाद they never came back. और वो जो sparrows होती हैं वो कभी भी वापिस नहीं आती. So let's see how it was the attachment between grandmother and sparrow. Okay, among will be saying there because among में क्या कि जो sparrows है they are in thousands. So sparrows and grandmother. And now the sixth question is that the author's grandmother was a religious person. Obviously she was religious because she was telling the beads of her rosary every day. What are the different ways in which we come to know this? What are the different ways? वो कौन से different ways हैं in which we come to know this? जिससे हमें इनका पता चलता है. तो कौन से different ways हैं यहाँ पे? When she lived in the village, the author she used to sing prayer in the mountainous sound. मतलब बहुत ही स्वीट सी साउंड है. Mountainous means बहुत ही स्वीट सी साउंड में वो क्या करती है, प्रेयर गाती है यहाँ पे. While getting him ready each morning, क्योंकि because it was her duty to make ready this author, because author that time he was just like a boy, he was just a child there. So like this you can look at the animation also, that how he was a very little child there and she was making him ready for the school. She used to walk an author to his school and then visit to temple and attached to the school every day. Means जो school के साथ जो temple attached था उसमें वो बैठ करके वहाँ पर scriptures पढ़ती थी. She would sit and read scriptures there. Means religious books वो यहाँ पर temple में बैठ के पढ़ती. And later when they moved to the city, और जब वो city में चले गए, जब वो कहाँ गए, city में settle हो गए, they would carry two beads. Oh, she would carry two beads of her rosary with her all the time. तो यहाँ पर क्या था, वो अपनी जो beads है, जो माला के मन के, वो rosary के यहाँ पर भी क्या करती रहती है, वो उनको मतलब यहाँ पर जपती रहती है यहाँ पे. She would continuously chant her prayer, means continuously वो prayer गाती रहती है and her hand remained busy in telling the beads. उसका मतलब जैसे होता है ना कि एक हाथ में तो माला के मन के होते हैं, माला होते उसके मन के, ऐसे वो गुनगुनाती रहती है, prayer गाती रहती है, माला के मन के जो वो फेरती रहती है ऐसे. जैसे जो वर्शिप है, वर्शिप के टाइम पे मोस्ट ऑफ द लेडीज को आपने देखा होगा, ऐसे सीरियल्स में होता है कि जो ओल्ड लेडीज होती है वो क्या करती है, अपने हाथ में माला रखती है, उसके मन को जपती रहती है और से प्रेयर को सिंग करती रहती है और अपने आप को रिलीजियस शो करती है. सो ऐसी लेडीज की तरह यहाँ पर ये ग्रैंड मदर होती है यहाँ पे. एंड वेन टू द आफ्टर दैट व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन द ऑथर वेंट टू स्टडी एट द यूनिवर्सिटी, जब यूनिवर्सिटी में वो चले जाते हैं, शी वेंट इनटू सेक्यूलिज्म एंड स्पेंट हर होल डे इन चैंटिंग प्रेयर. और जब वो आप जो चला जाता है खुशवंत सिंह, जब वो कहाँ चला जाता है, यूनिवर्सिटी में फर्दर स्टडी के लिए चला जाता है, देन ऑल्सो शी वॉज मेकिंग हर सेल्फ बिजी इन चैंटिंग और इन सिंगिंग द प्रेयर्स ओनली, स्पिनिंग द व्हील्स देयर एंड आफ्टर दैट व्हाट शी वॉज डूइंग, शी वॉज फीडिंग द स्पैरोज. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बिफोर यू, दैट इज डिस्क्राइब द चैंटिंग, describe the changing relationship between the author and his grandmother. So what are the changing relationship there? Did their feeling for each other change? क्या उनकी feeling भी change हो गई थी? क्या हुआ था भाई यहाँ पे? In early days, जो when they were in the village, they both shared a good bond. Means when they were in the village, they were very good friends there. And she would get him ready for school, accompany him. Means उसके साथ जाती थी and would come back or and they were coming back from the school there with him later in the day. And she would help him with his study also because religious subjects were in the school. Religious subjects were there in the school. That's why she was able to help him also and would teach him prayer by singing a mantra. On every morning, means बहुत ही sweet सी song में बहुत ही good song जो वो यहाँ पर prayer sing prayer जो यहाँ पर गुनगुनाती रहती है. फिर वो क्यों गाती है यहाँ पे? She was just singing the prayer, she was just chatting the prayer so that Khushwant Singh will also pay heed towards that, he will also pay attention towards that and he will learn that. But he had no more any interest in the prayer there. Okay, he was just listening because of her sweet voice. He was just listening only because of her sweet voice, but he had no interest to learn the prayer. So they would no longer accompany him. When they visit to city, what happened? They were starting to, when they visited to city. So what happened there? Their relation was changed there and he was going to English medium school and no longer now she was able to give a company to him in the school. She was not able to talk to him even she was not able to complete his homework there, help him in his homework. And third is there that she was just very, she was na, you know, she is starting talking about music lessons and she thought that this music subject should not be there because this is for the beggars or heralds there. And she heralds means here Vaishyaon ke liye hote hain. And she stopped talking to him afterward and would spend her day alone and while chanting the prayer. Means wow, how she was doing that? She was making herself busy in spinning the wheel, okay, and chanting the prayers and feeding the sparrow. So these are three things were there in which she was making herself the whole day busy. And when author went to university, then also there was great change in the relationship. Now hardly they were speaking to each other there, and she was now making busy herself in the spinning also, right? And their feelings for each other didn't change. Means their feelings were not changed, but during the time a distance developed between them. देखो यहाँ पे बोला क्या गया है. पहले जब वो village में थे तो उनका relation बहुत strong था. सिटी में आने के बाद रिलेशनशिप में काफी चेंज आया. उनके रिलेशनशिप में मतलब वो एक दूसरे से खास बात नहीं कर पाते थे, बट फिर भी उनकी फीलिंग्स यहाँ पर सेम है. मिस इतना ही रिस्पेक्ट वो अब भी अपने ग्रैंडमदर का करते हैं और इतना ही वो अफेक्शन अपने ग्रैंडसन से करती है. बट शी समहाउ अंडरस्टूड, कहीं ना कहीं उसको ये लगा कि नहीं, अब इनके पास मेरे लिए टाइम नहीं है और मैं इनको मतलब अगर मैं बात करना भी चाहूँ तो ये बहुत बिजी है. तो इसलिए उसने खुद ही एक डिस्टेंस मेंटेन करके रखा यहाँ पर, अब खुशवंत सिंह से, अपने सन से और उसकी मतलब वाइफ से. मींस कहने का कि एवरीबॉडी वाज बिजी इन देयर ओन वर्क एंड दी शी नेवर कंप्लेन टू एनीबॉडी एल्स दैट व्हाई दे वर लीविंग हर अलोन. And the next question, would you agree that the author's grandmother was a person strong in character? If yes, then you have to write. So what do you think? She was a strong character. Obviously, she was a strong character. And why she was a strong character? Because first of all, she never complained about her loneliness to anyone else. Okay. And she had her own thoughts about the school and their teachings also. She hated the English subjects there. Even then also, she was adjusting herself. And she didn't like music subject because according to her, music was the low level, third class of people subject there. According to grandmother then. And when the author went to the university, then also she made herself busy in spinning the wheel, in chanting the prayers and in telling the beads of rosary and in feeding the sparrows. Means she was adjusting herself in every kind of atmosphere, so she was not complaining about anybody else. And even she sang the song for homecoming of warriors also for hours and didn't stop even when her family was trying to million times. Means uske family wale bolte hai ki bhi ab to ruk jao, ab to band karo, but she matlab wo yahan par nahi ruki. Means she was just singing the songs of the homecoming of the warriors there. And during her last time also she didn't वेस्ट एनी टाइम इन द टोकिंग. उसने उसको पता था कि उसका एंड नियर है, तो उसने ना तो ये कहा कि मुझे अपने ग्रैंडसन से बात करनी है, ना उसने कहा कि मुझे अपने सन से बात करनी है. मींस शी हैड नो अटैचमेंट विद एनीबॉडी एल्स. और लास्ट में उसने वही किया जो बोर्ड के पास जाने से पहले हर किसी को करना चाहिए. मींस देखो, जब भी किसी की डेथ नियर होती तो कहते कि मतलब मेरे रिलेटिव को बुला दो, मुझे उनसे मिलना है, मेरा एंड नियर आ चुका है, अभी मुझे उन सबसे मिलना है. लेकिन यहाँ पर वो ये कहते कि उसने ऐसा कुछ नहीं किया. उसने ये नहीं कहा कि मेरा एंड नियर है तो मुझे मतलब मेरे ग्रैंडसन को बोलो मेरे सामने आए, मेरे पास आए, मेरे बेटे को बोलो मेरे सामने बैठेगा. ऐसा उसने कुछ भी नहीं कहा जो कि इमोशनल होता है. उसने इमोशंस को एक तरफ रख दिया और उसने कहा कि भाई सब कुछ साइलेंट हो गए और मुझे मेरी प्रेयर गाने दो और मुझे कोई भी डिस्टर्ब नहीं करेगा. तो यहाँ पर वो बड़ा स्ट्रॉन्ग कैरेक्टर है कि वो मतलब इतना स्ट्रॉन्ग है कि उसको पता कि अगर उसका एंड नियर है सो व्हाट शुड शी डू, उसको करना क्या चाहिए. शी शुड जस्ट रिमेंबर द गॉड एंड शी वॉज डूइंग द सेम देयर. सो अपने मतलब जब वो एक्सपायर होते हैं, उसके एक्सपायर होने से पहले वो है प्रेयर को चैंट कर रही होती है, मतलब भगवान का नाम ही ले रही होती है, गॉड का नेम ही उसकी लिप्स पर होता है. एंड इट शुड बी विद एवरीबॉडी. मींस अगर हमें पता है कि हमारा एंड नियर है सो वी शुड जस्ट स्टॉप दैट इमोशन देयर, बिकॉज यू नो व्हाट इज द रियलिटी ऑफ द लाइफ. द रियलिटी ऑफ द लाइफ इज देयर दैट नो रिलेशन विद गो विद अस बट ओनली द नेम ऑफ द गॉड विल गो विद अस, राइट. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज देयर, Which language do you think the author and his grandmother used while talking to each other? भी कौन सी लैंग्वेज यूज करेंगे. अब देखो पहले विलेज लाइफ में, विलेज में थे, फिर वो सिटी में गए, तो मीन्स दे आर बिलोंगिंग टू द विलेज देयर ना. और विलेज के अंदर जो ग्रैंड मदर, देखो ग्रैंड मदर को इंग्लिश तो आएगी नहीं यहाँ पर. एंड नाउ शी वी कैन से दैट शी दे वर टॉकिंग इन द मदर टंग देयर, तो वो मदर टंग में तो बात करेंगे अपने, ठीक है. एंड अनदर बिलोंग टू लाइक पंजाब, पंजाब स्टेट से बिलोंग करते हैं, दे वुड टॉक इन पंजाबी लैंग्वेज. तो ये क्या है, ये पंजाबी लैंग्वेज में ही यहाँ पर टॉक करेंगे, नॉट इन एनी अदर लैंग्वेज. ओके, सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट योर सॉल्यूशन एंड दिस वीडियो. एंड इफ यू वुड वांट टू वॉच माय प्रायर वीडियो इन विच आई टॉट यू अबाउट द समरी important words, so you can watch its first part. And if you have any confusion in writing section, hornbill book and snapshot, so you can just go to the channel and check the playlist. In the playlist you will find every kind of the video there. Thank you so much.